Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today I will explain you about shaft runout check and precision alignments in pumps and compressors. Type of misalignment. So here in the first picture you can see angular misalignment. So here you can see both the axes are in an angle. This is a one axis and this is a other axis. So this is the angle. So this is a angular misalignment. This is a offset or parallel. If your axes are up and down, then that is a offset, because axes are not in a same line. So this is a offset. This offset. Combination. So angular or offset combination may occur in generally in the prime mover and your driven shaft. So here you can see this is a combination of offset or angular misalignment. You can see a graph here for misalignment tolerance guide or flexibly coupled rotating machine. So here you can see in this axis maximum deviation at either point of power transmission. Mils per inch means, mils means 1 mil equal to 1 thou. Per inch of means dia of shaft, 1 mil per inch dia shaft. Here speed is given in RPM in multiplication of 1000. So if your alignment is 0.5 mils and this, and if your RPM is 8000, then it will be in acceptable range. So this is the area which is in acceptable range of alignment. If it beyond this, then realignment is necessary, and if it comes here in this zone, then it is very excellent. Here you can see angularity in degrees. Defective alignment results. The possible consequences of shaft misalignment are serious to equipment. Increased friction and thereby energy consumption. Premature bearing and mechanical seal failure. Or your coil seal failure. Premature shaft and coupling failure. Excessive seal lubricant leakage. If your seal will fail, then there will be a leakage of lubricant. Failure of coupling and foundation bolts. Because if alignment will adjust, then there will be a vibrations, and that will cause to failure of coupling and foundation bolts. Increased vibration and noise and pump foundation weakening. Excessive vibration will also weaken your foundation of pump and motor. What is shaft dynamic runout? Measurement of runout is typically performed using an instrument, a dial indicator, and reading are expressed as total indicator reading or full indicator movement. So that dial indicator is a device which is having a 1 mm movement in circular, and it is divided in 100 divisions. So one division will be 1 by 100 mm. Here in this slide you can see a picture, total indicated runout examples. Center of rotation. So this is TIR, total indicator reading. This is a deviation. Here also this is a deviation. This deviation, total indicator reading, that will be shown on the dial gauge. Dynamic runout is checked while rotating the shaft slowly in a shop setting. So the dynamic runout is checked when shaft is slowly rotated and it is capped on V block or in a lathe machine, and a dial indicator is put on the shaft, and shaft is rotated slowly and readings are recorded, and that will tell you how much is run out of the shaft. Shaft run out can vary length in a length of a shaft section to section. Assuming the same magnitude of total indicator reading, the type of run out that is shown on the left side of figure 1 is more damaging because the run out occurs twice per revolution here. As a result, the seal accumulate more compression relaxation cycles and experiences accelerated extrusions damage in high pressure service. How to measure shaft runout? You can see a picture where a pump is shown and a dial indicator is fixed on a shaft with the help of magnetic base. A dial indicator mounted on a magnetic base is being used to measure shaft runout as the shaft is being turned slowly. So here you can see, this is a magnetic base, this is a dial indicator, and this is a fixture for fixing dial gauge. This is a shaft. The runout measurement is reported in terms of the total movement of the indicator. Runout measurement in actual operating condition may be impractical to measure and are likely to be far greater than measurement taken while rotating the shaft slowly without actual operation loads. So shaft runout can be measured by two methods. One is a V block and other one is a lathe machine. Here you can see we are measuring the shaft runout itself in a field. So this may not give you a correct reading of the runout. Therefore, for measurement of shaft runout, shaft should be dismantled from the machine and it should be taken out, and then it should be put on the V block or it should be fixed in a lathe machine to measure the runout. Shaft alignment awareness. So what are the methods for shaft alignment? Straight edge, dial indicator, laser shaft alignment. So accuracy of straight edge is poor. Speed is good because we can do as fast as possible with a straight edge. Alignment can be done within few minutes. Easy to use. Dial indicator, accuracy is good, but it takes time. When we are doing alignment with dial indicators, with the help of dial indicators, you will take time. It can take 1 hour, 2 hours, or sometime it can take 4 hours also. Easy of use, there is a little difficulty in doing alignment with the dial indicators because perfection is required. Skilled technicians are required. Laser shaft alignment. This is the most advanced technique of alignment, which is nowadays used in all process industries. So accuracy of laser alignment is very good. Speed is also good. We can do fast alignment with the help of laser shaft alignment process, and it is easy to use. Benefit of alignment include improvement in vibration levels, reduced mean time between failures, and reduced maintenance cost. So your alarm with the laser shaft alignment will drastically reduced. If your alignment is perfect, then you will find the results of a good alignment. Precision alignment. A precision alignment will be achieved with dial indicators or laser indicators. The alignment method available at this stage include rim and face dial indicator method, reverse dial indicator method, and a laser alignment method. You can see a picture of a rim and face alignment method. So what we do? We generally mount fixtures on the motor and dial indicators are fixed on the pump shaft. So this indicator, this dial indicator will be used to take your radial readings, and this will be used for taking your axial readings or angular alignments. But in these methods there are some problems. So problems are loose fixtures. If your these fixtures are loose, not perfectly clamped, the wrong readings can be occurred. No repeatability. Indicator set at an angle. If your indicator is set at an angle, then that may not give you correct reading. Sagging in the fixtures. Correct readings are not possible sometimes, because readings comes in a positive or negative. So a perfect skilled technician is required who will note down the readings correctly. Did it start one way and go back? So how you measure? If you rotate the pump coupling in one way and then come back, or you take a complete round of it. So both methods can be applied, but sometime you may face some difficulties. Parallax. Parallax means you may not be correctly visualize the readings, because the readings are in a certain distance, and if you are not properly seeing the dial indicators perfectly, then you may have a wrong readings. In the reverse dial method, the dials are put on both the shafts, dial gauges. So here you can see the clamp is fixed here, and this dial indicator is fixed here, and this clamp is fixed here, and dial indicator is fixed on the motor. So we will take the readings of both and we'll see whether alignment is coming perfect or not. So there are also some problems. Here it is for radial misalignment or offset, axis offset. Bearing looseness. If your bearing is loose, then this may not give you correct readings. Loose fixtures, the same problem as we discussed earlier. Correct indicator, mounting or reading right. Mounting of a dial gauge is improper, and if your readings are not rightly noted. Sticking indicators, sometime your this indicator, dial gauge indicator may stick to the shaft and will not give you a correct reading. Correct clock position. Clock position means this is shaft is divided in four sections like this. 0, 90 degree, 270 degree and 360. So 0 and 360 will come at the same point. Sagging in the fixtures, clamps and parallax as we discussed earlier. So these are the potential problems which may not give you a correct readings. However, in industry generally the alignment is carried out with the help of dial indicators by remand face method or the reverse dial indicator method. Laser alignment. A picture of laser alignment is shown here. You can see this is a laser alignment machine. Laser alignment is very accurate method for alignment. It can reduce number of alarms of rotating machines and improve performance in measurable terms. So here you can see in the picture A, this is a axis offset, this is an angular offset, and here this is a correct alignment. Both the axes are in the one line and there is no angular edge. So this C is the correct alignment, and if your alignment comes in a accurate condition, means alignment should not be exceed more than 0.05 mm in any case, that should be treated as a good alignment. If it is well within the 3 divisions of your dial indicator means 0.03 mm, then it will be a perfect alignment. But if your alignment of those pumps which are having mechanical seals and alignment is exceeding more than 5 divisions or 0.05 mm, then those pumps will not give you perfect service or a long service, because due to misalignment you will face lot of problems of seal failure, bearing failures and vibrations. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.